music could always wait, but if I needed to get a job at some point, I needed to have a degree. I like to call us sort of regionally famous. It's fun. It's really cool to be, you know, in a restaurant or at a movie and have someone say, "Oh, hey, are you in Heiruspecs?"
Listen, we may see these tapes and wax and tours and stores, yet start on tracks. Turn the blind eye to haters, dreaming that we had a gimmick that was right after high school. We wasn't thinking about an image. I know, cause really Heiruspecs.
In the band for a few years, we went through a number of lineup changes. We first had a horn section. We had my friend Martin Devaney playing saxophone.
Interesting. It's been an interesting juggling act. Because I think, like, you know, all of us have jobs, but all of us also play music for a living. And sometimes it just takes balancing those two to, like, make it make sense.
Youngest brother Jacob also plays guitar now and takes lessons from Matt Prudell, the same person that I took lessons from, and is working on starting a band also.
It's hard to gather everyone together and have everyone in the same place at the same time. There's usually one person that can't make it, so then we just don't have practice.
Arts program there, Red Freeburg's class, which was a huge influence both on me and on Heiruspecs as a whole. It was an amazing experience to get to go to school and to just jam with people.
So I feel like I ask this at every show, but it's gonna sound like a stupid question tonight, but how many people here are actually from St. Paul? And most shows I ask that, it's a super split decision. Everybody's like, "Oh, I'm from Minneapolis, I'm just over here."
Why I do it, you know? I don't know why that flame burns, but it does. And, you know, it doesn't for everybody, and that's, you know, it's somewhere else. So I don't expect everybody to understand it, but you expect everybody at least to hopefully accept it.
It goes wrong, incidentally, your documentary on heavy metal got me thinking about the product you peddle. Started getting paranoid, meddling with verses, it's rhymeless, trying to find a new thing that's timeless. I confuse the mind, kid. You ever think about the very...
I always looked at it as, I didn't want to make musicians. I didn't think that was my primary function. I thought my primary function was to make sure that people would have a connection in music for the rest of their life. So many people that are willing to be passive and be an audience. And it doesn't take that much to be a creator.
Whether or not music is ever, you know, what I do for a living, like full time, it's always something I'll be doing all the time. And it, you know, it may or may not be my main source of income, but it will be the main source of my passion, and it will be the main source of my time spent. And I don't see that ever going away.
People in my bands are also some of my best friends, which is a really cool thing, because when I'm, you know, out on the road playing shows with them, it's not like it's, you know, a job and I'm dreading it. It's like, I'm hanging out with my friends and I happen to get to play some music, and these people are going to happen to listen to it and be really into it, and then afterwards they're going to come up to me and say, "Oh, hey, that was a really great show, you know, your music means a lot to me." So I think that well, originally it was so I could, you know, play these little lame songs with my friend on Saturday afternoons. It turned into like a way to connect with all sorts of different people.
My recycling truck might be loud.
Oh, that's alright.
Yeah, aftermath of the party last week.